This is StoryBeat, Storytellers on Storytelling, an exploration into how master storytellers and artists develop and build brilliant stories and works of art that people everywhere love and admire. So join us as we discover how talented creators of all kinds find success in the worlds of imagination and entertainment. Here now is your host, Steve Cuden.
Thanks for joining us on StoryBeat. We're coming to you from the Center for Media Innovation on the campus of Point Park University in the heart of downtown Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. My guest today, Michael Colleary, has been a screenwriter, producer, educator, and screenwriting consultant for more than three decades. He earned an MFA from the UCLA Film School, where he won the Jack Nicholson Award and the William Morris Award for Screenwriting Excellence. Michael has worked for all the major movie studios and TV networks. His credits include Lara Croft, Tomb Raider, the family comedy Firehouse Dog, and the TV series Unnatural History. Michael won a Saturn Award for co-writing with Mike Werb, the highly popular John Woo-directed action thriller Face Off, starring John Travolta and Nicolas Cage. The New York Times deemed it one of the best 1,000 movies ever made. Since the mid-1990s, Michael has been a visiting instructor for the MFA in Screenwriting program at UCLA, where he teaches the famed 434 Screenwriting Workshop. For the record, I had the great pleasure of meeting Michael when I was a grad student in UCLA's screenwriting program more than 10 years ago. His students have gone on to write, direct, and/or produce such movies and television series as The Bad Batch, Patriot, Bojack Horseman, The Punisher, and many more. For his tireless contributions to the program, UCLA honored him with the prestigious Lew and Pamela Hunter, Jonathan and Janice Zakin Chair in Screenwriting. Currently, Michael is the co-creator and showrunner for the television series Professionals, starring Tom Welling and Brendan Fraser, which recently wrapped production in South Africa for a 2020 premiere. For those reasons, and so many more, I'm truly thrilled beyond words to have one of the great masters of screenwriting, Michael Colleary, on StoryBeat today. Michael, welcome to the show.
Thank you. Thank you so much. And that actually sounded very impressive. for someone who generally works in his pajamas, that sounded really good.
Did you ever shoot an elephant in your pajamas? All right, so what were your earliest inspirations and influences? What was your first creative love? How did you get down this road?
I think everyone's journey is unique. Mine was perhaps destined slightly. My dad was a TV writer and producer his whole career.
Right?
And he started off in the early days of television back in New York. When really there really was no industry yet. It was still developing. But anyway, he ended up being the head writer of Captain Kangaroo.
Really?
Which is a your younger listeners may not recall the captain, but certainly baby boomers would.
Yes.
And it was sort of a Mr. Rogers, Sesame Street type daily show for children that was made out of New York. So I definitely grew up, although my dad was like a lot of dads and just went into the New York City every day to work and on the bus and came home every day. Pretty standard middle class suburban upbringing. It was also kind of a industry family. We went away. You know, he had the summers off and we went away. And so we definitely had a very lovely lifestyle growing up, thanks to him being in the television business and in show business. So I think when you grow up in that environment, maybe you just absorb it naturally. I didn't want to be in the industry when I went through high school and stuff. I wanted to be a journalist, and I first went to college to be a journalist. And it was really just kind of by accident that I fell into, you know, I just fell in love with the movies. Unfortunately, when you go to fortunately or unfortunately, I found when I went to college, like there were free movies everywhere in the student union, in the dormitories, and you know, film programs and all that stuff. And so I was goofing off a lot, and I just ended up going to the movies all the time.
Right.
And I just really fell in love with the movies. So that's how I ended up kind of steering my way into this business.
What was the first movie you remember having an influence on you?
Oh, my gosh. The first movie, and to this day, it still resonates with me, believe it or not, was the original Batman. Now, I was a kid. I was born in 1960.
Yeah.
So I was at 6 or 7 when the Batman TV show was on with Adam West back in the mid-60s. And then they made a film. They made a movie that came out like the summer of 66 or something like that. And I will never forget the feeling I had in my gut when I was sitting in the theater in Bayhead, New Jersey, when I realized that all the Batman villains from the TV episodes were in the same movie.
Mm-hmm.
Because usually they went week to week.
Sure.
The Joker, the Riddler, whoever, one villain a week on the TV show. But in the movie, they were all in the movie. And it just seemed like an insurmountable level of bad guys that Batman could, you know, he would never be able to handle all of that evil. And that made a big impression on me, even to this day. I still remember, like, as a kid, it was maybe the first time in a movie where I felt like so connected to what was going on that I actually was afraid for Batman and Robin, which I think was the point, which is, I think, what they were trying to create. But
sure.
They got me.
You had a true young person's visceral experience on that.
Yes, I did. I did. And actually, I saw a similar thing in my daughter many, many, many years later when my daughter was about, she was a little younger, she was maybe 3 or 4, and we went to see, what was that wonderful movie with Amy? Enchanted? Amy Adams, is that the one?
I think it is called Enchanted. Yeah, I think so.
Enchanted, yeah. And we went to see it at the Crest Theater here in Hollywood, in L.A., and we sat in the balcony, and she got so into the movie. She was in her Disney princess outfit, and she was sitting next to me in the movie, and she got so into the movie that at the end, when the dragon's on the flying around,
yeah,
and there's all this kind of action, she literally leapt at the screen, and like I had to grab her from going over the balcony. Yeah, she was so engaged in this whole thing. So I have definitely seen it in my kids too, and it actually is a wonderful, you know, it's what makes it so gratifying, really, if you're fortunate enough to evoke that in people.
Well, yeah.
That's the magic part.
That is the part that we drag people into that world, and they get lost in it because they have such a deep sense of feeling about it.
Yeah, and it's very gratifying. It's great to see it in a movie. It must be fantastic to watch it in the actual theater.
Oh.
I'm assuming you spent an evening or afternoon watching, sitting in the audience or standing in the back watching people respond in the theater. I think that must be
it's a thrill
that must be.
It's an extraordinary thing, especially the very first time or times when an audience live is watching a live performance and they're on their feet at the end. That's just chilling. It's fun.
I bet. That's very, that must be unbelievably gratifying.
It truly is. All right, so when did you first, I mean, your father was a writer, working with Bob Keeshan and Lumpy Branham and all those good people.
This was the 60s. This was the, the Mad Men era in a way.
Yeah.
And they would come over. My father apparently was famous for his martini. And we would have the cast of Captain Kangaroo over. Not Keeshan so much. Apparently he kept it himself a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Was a bit of a Michael Scott kind of figure, I think, among
is that right?
the cast and crew. A little bit, yeah. I mean, not as needy, but maybe more like the Michael Scott of the English, The Office. But anyway, my dad was very close with Lumpy Brennan and Gus Allegretti, who did all the puppetry.
Right.
And the other writers, my dad's gone now, but the other writers on the show are still family friends.
Well, that's really neat.
To this day. And yeah.
So then when did you, obviously you had this influence in your life, but when did you think to yourself, I think I would like to do that. I'd like to write. When did you start to write?
I was in college and I had been, I jumped around, I had a typical kind of chaotic, I don't know if that's